Open your book to page 432. And let's start with number 11. You have 9 to the 1 half power plus 16 to the 1 half power square. When you have this kind of problem, these are terms, so do not distribute this over to cancel out the exponents. What you need to do is you have to work out each part because these are terms. So 9 to the half power is the 3, 16 half power is 4, and you have to work this out so you get 7 squared, and so you get 49. Okay, so you can do not distribute this and make it into 9 plus 16 and becomes 25, and it would be incorrect. Okay, let's go to number 17. Number 17, you have cube root of 8, b to the 6, c to the negative 4. And this one, you want to write it in the exponential form. So just go and make into 1/3 power for each part. And so 6 over 3 will give you 2. And this would be negative 4 over 3. And this one you can simplify. 8 is equal to 2 to the 3. So change the 8 into 2 to the 3. And 3 and 1/3 power will becomes 1. So this is just equal to 2b squared c to the negative 4 over 3. Let's go to number 29. Yeah, 9 times square root of cube root of 9. Let's go and convert this into 3 squared times. And so this one, 9 is going to be 3 squared. Now cube root will give you 1/3 power. And that square will give you 1/2 power. So again, so start from the inside, you're working it out. And so this becomes 3 squared times this and this becomes 1, so it becomes 3 to the 1/3 power. And so this is equal to missing this part, but 3 to the x. And so this becomes 3 to the 2 and 1/3 equal to 3 to the x. Normally you stay away from the mixed numbers, but since you already have it, so just leave it. Or if you want to, you can convert to improper fraction. So either way. So that's it for number 29. Okay, let's go to number 35. Number 35, you have the 10th root of 32 divided by the 8th root of 4. So what you want to do is, again, convert to the lowest base. So 32 is 2 to the 5. And 10th root is 1/10 power divided by 4 is 2 squared. And 8th root is 1/8 power. So go and work it out. So you got 2 to the 5 over 10 will give you 1/2 power. And 2 times 1/8 will be 1 over 4. Okay, so when you divide, you subtract the exponent. So this is equal to, so 1/2 minus 1/4 is 1/4. And so this is equal to the 4th root of 2. Okay, let's go to page 435. And let's start with, page 435. Let's start with 1c. You have 5 to the square root of 2 plus 2 divided by 5 to the square root of 2 minus 2. So when you have division, you have to subtract the exponent. So this is equal to 5 to the, and you have to be careful when you subtract, especially you have negative over here. So you end up with square root of 2 plus 2 minus square root of 2 minus 2. Right? So use this minus that. Right? And so this is equal to, and again, when you subtract, you have to watch the signs. So you get square root of 2 plus 2 minus square root of 2 plus 2. So this becomes 5 to the 4. So this is equal to 6 to 5. Okay, so you can watch the signs over here. Okay, let's go to 17. Number 17, you have an 8 to the 2 plus x is equal to 2. To solve for x, you have to make into lower space so you can match. So 8 equal to 2 to the 3. And I'm going to put this equal to 1. And then you go and multiply out the exponents using the power rule. So you get 2 to the 6 plus 3x. Remember to distribute, remember to multiply the x. So from here, you can just do the matching. So you got, so 2 match with the 2, 6 plus 3x equal to 1. Minus 6. So 3x equal to negative 5 divided by 3 divided by 3. So x equal to negative 5 over 3. Let's go to number 25. You have 25 to the 2x equal to 5 to the x plus 6. So again, let's go and change into the lower space, which is 5, so you can match up. So you get 5 squared to the 2x equal to 5 to the x plus 6. So use the power rule, so you get 5 to the 4x equal to 5 to the x plus 6. And do the matching, you got 4x equal to x plus 6 minus x on both sides. So you got 3x equal to 6 divided by 3 divided by 3, so x equal to 2. Let's go to page 444. And let's do number 5. You have log of 1/8 base 2. And you want to evaluate. Whenever you're going to evaluate, you want to set it equal to x. That way when you move things around, you're still able to keep track of what you're doing. And next is, you're going to evaluate, you want to go and change form. Okay, so this becomes, again, the base state, right? And this crisscross, right? So 2 to the x equal to 1 over 8. And then after that, you try to change to the base so that it can match up. So 2 to the x equal to 1 over 2 to the 3. And you have to flip it over. So this is equal to 2 to the negative 3. By doing the matching, x equal to negative 3. And so that's what you have. Yeah, that's what it's equal to. Now let's go to number 15. You have log 8 1/2. So this is very similar to that. So set it equal to x, then you can go ahead and change form. So you got 1/2 to the x equal to 8. Right? Again, the base stay and the other two numbers crisscross, right? I can change everything in the base 2. So this is 1 power, so when you flip it over, you get 2 to the negative 1. And this is 2 to the 3. And so you're going to get 2 to the negative x equal to 2 to the 3. By matching it up, you can see negative x equal to 3. So x equal to negative 3. Okay. So you can notice they are very similar, right? Okay, and they're the same. Okay, let's go to number 23. Number 23, you have log x base 4 equal to negative 3 over 2. So this is same as before. When you evaluate, you set it equal to x, it becomes solving. And so this is just exactly like the previous problems. So go ahead and change form. So 4 to the negative 3 over 2 power equal to x, right? I can crisscross the numbers. And all you have to do is just go and evaluate this part. So change the 4 into 2 squared. And multiply out, so you get 2 to the negative 3 power equal to 8, equal to x. And so you can flip this over, so 1 over 2 to the 3 power equal to x, so x equal to 1 over 8. Okay, let's go to page 449. And let's do number 5. Number 5, you have log of m to the 4 over n3 base 2. And this one you want to break them up. You want to change this into log m and log n. So first, this is division, so you have to separate this. So separate them. So you got m to the 4. Now division, when you separate, it becomes minus. And next, you have to bring the exponent down. So this is equal to 4 log m base 2 minus 3 log n base 2. Notice the way you write the base should be kind of small and it's a subscript. Okay, let's go to number 23. 23 is kind of going the opposite way. So you got 2 log a base 3 minus 1 half log b base 3. So you're going to reverse. So you have to bring the exponents in. Okay, so you got log a squared base 3 minus log b 1 half base 3. Next is when you have subtraction of the logs, it becomes the division. So you got, so this is going to be equal to log of a squared over, now b to the 1 half power is square root, right? So square root of b and the base 3. And so that's it. Okay. Okay, let's go to page 462. Let's do number 19. You have 3 over 2 natural log of 4 plus 2. And you want to combine it into a single log. But in order to do that, you need to, if you have natural log, you need to have a natural log over here. But you don't have, so you need to add something into it. So what you need to do is, you need to add this part. Okay? So you need to add natural log of e. Right? Because this is equal to 1. Because that natural log means it's base e. So you get base e of the e, so it becomes 1. So you have to add this part so you have a natural log so you can combine them. Okay, so now you can go and do the regular steps. So you can bring this in there. So you got natural log of 4 to the 3 squared, 3 over 2 power, plus natural log of e squared. Now, when you have addition, it becomes multiplication, right? So this becomes natural log of 4, 3 over 2 power, e squared. Now you need to simplify this part. Okay. So 4 is 2 squared. Okay. And so this cancel becomes 2 to the 3 power, e to the 2. And normally, if you have a simple number, you don't want to leave it like that. So you just go and multiply out. So this is equal to natural log of 2 to the 3 power is 8. And so it would be 8 e to the 2. And that would be your answer. Again, make sure you show your step, going down step by step. Okay, let's go to number 23. You have natural log of x to the 3 equal to 12. So you want to solve, so again you change form. Again, natural log means it's base e. So there's an invisible base e over here. So when you change form, the base stays the same. Again, there's an invisible e. Right? So e over here and switch. So it'd be e to the 12 equal to x to the 3. So in this case, what you need to do is you want to solve for x, so you have to get rid of the 1/3 power. So what you need to do is you have to raise everything to the 1/3 power. Okay? So I'm going to write it again so easier for you to follow. So what you do is you raise it to the 1/3 power to get rid of the 3. So you do the same on this side. So you end up with e to the 4 equal to x. And that would be your answer. Okay, let's go to page 455. Page 455, and let's do number 25. You have log of 9 base 2, and you want to find out what this is equal to. Now, on your calculator, it only gives you the natural log and common log. So it does not give you the base 2. So in order to use calculator, you have to convert into natural log or the common log. So I'm going to convert this into common log. So this is equal to log of 9 over log of 2. And again, when there's no base, means it's base 10. So now you can use your calculator now. Okay, it's on your calculator. So you get 9 log. Okay, so this is equal to 0.9542 divided by natural log of 2, which is 0.3010, and you push equal. This will give you 3. And let's see. Okay, it doesn't tell you how many decimals, so usually you want to go decimal places when you deal with logs. So it'd be 1699. Okay. And that's it. Okay, so you want to round it off to the 4 decimal places. Okay, let's go to page 458. So this one, you got 3 type of problems. So let's go ahead and do number 1. Okay, so this one, number 1, it says a radioactive gas radon has a half-life. So that's H. So you can write down all your information. 3.8 days. It says how much of a 5-gram sample remain. So the original amount, so this is decay, right? So your original amount is X0. So equal to 5 gram. So it didn't give you decimal, so 5 grams. And you're looking for these. You're looking for the amount after. So you can write down all your information after 4.2 days. So T equal to 4.2 days. So again, so this is radioactive decay. So start with your equation. X equal to X0 times 2 to the negative T over H. So put everything in there. So X equal to 5 times 2 to the negative 4.2 over 3.8. So X equal to, now make sure you know how to use your calculator and make sure you know the sequence. Okay. Okay, so so I'm going to start with this, so it'll be 2 to the parentheses 4.2 divided by 3.8 negative closing parentheses equal, okay, so that's this part over here, and times it by 5, and so this with X equal to 2.3 grams. I probably just give extra decimal. Again, it doesn't really matter, so let's just give 2 decimal places. Okay. And so that's it. Okay. Okay, let's go to number 3. Okay, number 3, again, read through, you know that this is the investment problem. It says some years ago, Ms. Martinez invest. So that's your invest. So that's your original amount. So your original amount is the principal. So P is your original amount, which is equal to $10,000 at 12% compound interest at 12% compounded monthly. So R equal to 12%, so 0.012. And then the compound monthly, right? So that means n equal to 12, means you're going to get compounded 12 times in 1 year. Okay? It says the account now contains $30,000. So that's amount of the money. It's $30,000 now. Okay, how long ago? So you're looking for the time. So that's what you're looking for. Again, write down all your information. Now this is an investment problem, so you start with your equation. So you got A equal to P times 1 plus R over N to the NT. So substitute everything in here. So amount at the end is $30,000. Principal is how much you invested in the beginning. Okay, R is your interest rate, so 0.12. Again, make sure it's in decimal. And N is 12. Okay. So N is how many times it compound in 1 year. Since it's compounded monthly, therefore it'll be 12 times in 1 year. Okay, so okay, first that's going to divide by 10,000. Right, so this will cancel out. So you get 3 equal to 1 plus, and this part of it, if you divide this over here, so you can work out this part over here. So 0.12 divided by 12 equal, and plus 1 equals, so this gives you 1.01 to the 12t. Okay. Now, whenever the variable is in the exponent, to solve that, you have to take the log. Okay, so I'm going to take the log on both sides. And I'm using the common log, so that's why there's no number of it. It means it's base 10. So take the log on both sides. And now, after I take the log, now this can come to the front. So log 3 equal to 12t log of 1.01. So now to solve for t, I'm going to divide by 12 and divide by log 1.01. So t equal to log 3 divided by 12 divided by log 1.01. Now when you divide, you have to be very careful, okay? Do not push multiplication key when you're doing the calculator. You have to use this to divide by 12, and you have to divide by that. Okay? So 3 log divided by 12, push equal, then divided by 1.01 log, push equal. So t equal to 9.2, and this would be years. Now, if you want to convert into months, you can, but you don't have to. You can just keep it as a 9.2 years. Okay. If you were to convert to month, then what you do is, this would be 9 years. Then the 0.2, right? So 0.2 year, you have to times it by 12, because there are 12 months per year, so this will give you 2.4 months. So again, this is month per year, okay, and this is the year, right? So the year will cancel out, so it become month. Now, but you know, when you're in a bank, when the interest, they don't give you half of the month. So you know, so in order to make that amount, you need to go to the, you have to run it up, so it'd be 3 months. Okay, so this is another option. So on the test, you can do either way. I will accept either one. But to be more exact, you should use this one. Okay, let's go to number 5. Okay, number 5, it says, if the population of the city doubles every 50 years, so in other words, t equal to 50 years, double means, so this is how to do with the population growth. So in this case, n equal to twice initial. Again, n zero means at time zero. So at the end, the population at the end is twice of the original amount, right? That's what double means. So you can have to understand what that means. And this one has a second scenario. It says, how long does it take? Okay, so this one is looking for t equal to amount for it to take to triple. So n equal to 3 times n0. Okay. So what you need to do is you have to use this information to find the growth constant, which is the k. So you need to look for the k on this one. Then use that to update your equation and then solve after that. So let's go and do that. Okay, so you have n equal to n0 times 2 to the kt. And so you got 2n0 equal to n0 times 2 to the t is 50, right? So k times 50. So everything, so you can write down your equation, substitute, then you work it out. So divide both sides by n. So divide both sides by n0. So this cancels out. So you got 2 to the 1 equal to 2 to the 50k. So by matching, okay, by matching 1 equal to 50k. So k equal to 1 over 50. Now once you find k equal to 1 over 50, you update your equation. So your equation is n equal to n0 times 2 to the so k is 150, so it'd be t over 50. So that's your updated equation, just like a proportional equation that you learned before, right? You always look for the constant and you update your equation. So now you can look for the time. Okay, so again, so substitute, so you got 3 n0. Again, the end equal to 3 times the original. Okay? So divide by n0 on both sides. So you got 3 equal to 2 to the t over 50. Now, again, when you're solving for variable and exponents, you need to go and take the log on both sides. So take the log on both sides. This one you don't have to because they are the same base, so you can get away with it. This one, they are different, so you have to take the log on both sides. So once you take the log, now the exponent can come to the front. Okay, next I'm going to multiply both sides by 50 to get rid of the fraction. So multiply by 50, so I get 50 log of 3 equal to t log of 2. Next, divide by log of 2. So t equal to, so this cancel out. So now I can evaluate, so I can get a calculator. So 50 times log of 3 equal divided by log of 2 equal, so this is 79.25 years. So if you run up to 79, or doesn't matter how many decimal, I'm not really picking on that. So if you go, so actually it's 48. So if you go 79.2, that's close enough.